He runs this house, he rules this crib. I'm financially intimidated, yeah, that's no fib. Boss Baby has, at its core, always been about family and the brotherly bond between Tim and Boss Baby Ted. But through two movies, a television series with over 50 episodes, an interactive special, and more, the franchise has certainly grown past its infancy. My name is Noah, and to catch up in time for the new TV series, The Boss Baby Back in the Crib, this is a quick Boss Baby recap. The Boss Baby. Boss Baby, though little, made his debut on the big screen. Here's the important stuff that was established. Baby Corp is a secret organization that churns out babies for the families of the world. Business-savvy babies are held back to work at the company by being given secret formula that allows them to retain their adult intelligence, without which they'll revert to their natural baby form. Baby Corp's main goal? Use a capitalist approach to profit the most love from the world via their adorableness. The competition? Puppies, kittens, charming vagabonds, you name it. Our titular Boss Baby, Ted, infiltrates the home of the Templetons, much to the chagrin of older brother Tim. See, their parents work for Puppy Co., where a nefarious scheme to overtake Baby Corp's market share is being hatched. The Boss Baby is a ruckus tale of brotherhood, trust, and adventure. After working with Tim to thwart the evil plans of Puppy Co. founder Francis E. Francis, the Boss Baby gives up a lucrative promotion and high IQ to permanently become Theodore Templeton as a regular, adorable baby. Until The Boss Baby, Back in Business, seasons 1 through 3. Yeah, Ted is most certainly still Boss Baby at the start of The Boss Baby, Back in Business. But even though he's still boss, Ted has indeed grown to love being a Templeton and is committed to being a part of the family. Unfortunately, that now brings the ultimate challenge of balancing work life with said family life. Thankfully, the Boss Baby isn't without assisting subordinates, friends and family. Stacy's devious mind is always thinking outside the crib. Gentle Giant Jimbo helps pacify a tense boardroom with his zen, and the triplets are triple the wild card that any maverick company needs. But at home, it's Tim who helps Ted understand what's really important. Season 1 begins with Mega Fat CEO Baby making infant life a little tough for Theodore. Not that it's undeserved, Ted definitely tried to politic his way to the top by taking advantage of Mega Fat in their relative youth, creating the fussy rival that overtook him for the coveted CEO position. Forget a promotion, our Boss Baby will be lucky to keep his job.
And then I get to fire you, just so we clear. We cleared up, baby!
Thankfully, the transcendent board of directors collectively supersedes the CEO position, so it's not like Mega Fat can call all the shots. Work drama aside, Baby Corp has a bigger problem. With the puppy threat gone, who next could threaten the love for babies? Sure, the obvious answer is cats and kittens, but come on, surely they can't be a threat. Well, mad veterinarian Bootsy Calico, who was raised by cats, mind you, develops a deep grudge against Boss Baby for exploiting his cat mother via the iconic Hang In There motivational poster. At first, it seems Bootsy's plan is to steal love away from babies and direct it to cats. Sounds familiar, but do cats really want attention and love? No, they prefer vengeance. Bootsy uses 6 well-placed kittens to disable the city's power structures and utilities to force the town into chaos, resulting in no love for anyone. Boss Baby and friends thwart the cuddly scheme, proving his worth as boss and little brother. Even better, Mega Fat CEO Baby is exposed for working with Calico to get rid of Theodore at Baby Corp, leaving an open CEO position, only to immediately be filled in season 2 by turtleneck superstar CEO Baby.
You're not the new CEO.
Really? She's organized, she's efficient, she seems quite wise and experienced for her age. Weird. But hey, great singing voice. She focuses Baby Corp's resources on a great new product, a special stinky serum that takes away babies' one true weakness, their nasty baby smells, and diapers and the like. This coincides with a summer-long visit to the family, much to the joy of Tim, Grandma Templeton. Unfortunately, she immediately butts heads with fussy Theodore. Too old-fashioned to readily accept babies in suits, I guess. The timing couldn't be any worse, as Frederick Estes of the Consortium of Ancients declares war on babykind on behalf of the elderly. His mission, to steal some attention from babies and direct it to the old geezers who really need it. Out with the new, in with the old. And now the elderly have a team member in Boss Baby's house via Grandma. The elderly aren't the only enemy Boss Baby faces in season 2. Bug the Pug, an agent from Nemesis Puppy Co., also shows up to attempt to infiltrate the Templeton household, proving that even corporate wars are never fought on only one front. That's not even where the infiltration ends. As it turns out, Turtleneck Superstar is actually Estes' elderly wife.
I am old people.
And the whole stinky serum is a deep conspiracy meant to decrease elderly stink, but then increase infant stink and ruin baby perception forever. During all this, having to share a room puts a temporary rift between brothers Tim and Ted, but they learn to coexist and use their brotherhood to help save babykind once more, with the help of their Gigi. Towards the end of Turtleneck Superstar's fraudulent tenure, Boss Baby is finally given a chance at the high chair of CEO after accidentally creating the nefarious reverse stinky serum formula.
I'm the CEO?
He immediately crashes and burns, treating everyone below him like garbage. This, coupled with the chaos he's consistently brought to Baby Corp, leads to Theodore being completely let go by the board of directors. Fired!
You're fired.
What?
Leaving him to try to find a new purpose in unemployment before he reverts to a normal baby when the severance formula runs out. It doesn't take long to find a project, as he recruits fellow babies from his local mommy-daddy playgroup for a startup baby corp of sorts. Everything is going great until a mysterious babblist named Happy Sedengri arrives at the playgroup. He claims to know how to speak to babies, but it's all an elaborate tickling ruse for profit, allowing parents to communicate with their beloved children years before they can actually talk. He falsely identifies Theodore as hating his beloved new playgroup, so Tim and Ted have no choice but to expose his scheme on local television. With his business squashed, Happy changes business tactics to Babizi Corp, specializing in ultra-safe toys and environments for babies, within which it's really hard to get any business done. They're playpen prisons. Babies everywhere hate Babizi, but Baby Corp refuses to go after the new threat.
Gotta give a big thank you to Babizi, the company that's made our job so easy.
So Boss Baby and the playgroup, with the help of new friend Megafat, expose Happy once more. The board of directors is so impressed, Ted is promoted to CEO legitimately. This time, he vows to do a good job, if he can clean up the corporate mess that was left for him. The Boss Baby, get that baby. A quick break in the Back in Business Chronicles for the Boss Baby, get that baby. Ever wanted to see what job you'd be placed in at Baby Corp? You're in luck. This interactive Netflix short unites the three iconic villains from Back in Business, Bootsy Calico, Frederick Estes, and Happy Sedengri. But just where this adventure takes Ted and company is up to you, the viewer, as you dictate choices, mostly business decisions, that vastly alter how the story unfolds. The Boss Baby Back in Business continued. Season 4. Now CEO, Boss Baby runs quite an efficient operation. Baby Corp's business is through the roof. This makes Theodore a little ambitious.
We're going to fill the pie chart. 100%.
Greedy. Babies are represented in the love pie chart, measuring tangible love, of course, by the color yellow. They're taking up more and more of the heart chart, but why stop at a simple majority? Introducing Yellow 100, the plan to monopolize all love for the babies and nobody else. All is going well until a brand new threat emerges. An infectious new kid show with an earworm of a theme song that has gripped the community. No, not the Boss Baby Back in Business. South American smash sensation Pig and Tam Love Babies, starring Maria Maria. Pig being a pygmy goat, Tam being a Tamandua, and Maria Maria being their translator. It's so cute it hurts. Profit margins, that is. Tam, Pig, and Maria Maria are more than just unassuming kid show hosts. Through their mutual connection of Bug the Pug, they actually know all about Baby Corp and want to turn it into a television studio. They're brutal showrunners, and ultimately competition to Baby Corp that needs to be taken down. And internal rivalries at work are still popping up for Boss Baby, particularly in the form of OCB, Outside Consultant Baby, an ultra-ambitious baby after the CEO job himself, who is very good at impressing the board of directors. Fortunately for Ted, OCB slips up in front of boardhead Emiliano and rapidly falls from grace, vowing revenge. With their public image ruined, Maria Maria, Pig, Tam, and Bug the Pug team up with OCB to form an attack by committee on Baby Corp, the most organized threat Boss Baby has ever faced. They successfully conquer Baby Corp, forcing the entire bureau to operate out of the Templeton's basement. The worst part, all of the baby's magic teleportation and anti-aging technology are locked within Baby Corp. Fortunately, local kid and preak ruffians help the babies and Tim gain access to Baby Corp via a neighborhood back door. The puppy, pygmy goat, Tamandua, and rival infant are successfully thwarted, and Yellow 100, the ultimate corporate goal, has finally been achieved. For about 2 seconds until a new adorable threat emerges. Ted learns that perfection is unrealistic, and that perhaps he's done all he can as CEO and Boss Baby in general. It's time to become a real baby, and then a real boss. The Boss Baby, family business. Now everyone is an adult, and typically a bit estranged. How very sad. Tina, Tim's youngest daughter, takes after her uncle and works for Baby Corp as new Boss Baby. Dr. Erwin Armstrong wants the very best for children, from children. Basically, he wants to hyper-accelerate child development and add them to the world's workforce, which could mean the end of childhood and the end of baby utility as Baby Corp knows it. This sounds like a job for the greatest Boss Baby in the company's history. Recruited by Tina, Theodore returns to Baby Corp through a new super-duper baby formula that turns him back into a baby. Now the brilliant heralded Boss Baby Ted can get back in the field to sneak into Armstrong's school to foil the ambitious atrocity. Oh, and Tim's also back to being 7 again. Dr. Armstrong's plan is actually more devious than first imagined. Turns out he's a baby. A very bad baby who wants to turn the adult population into mindless zombies privy to his whim. With the help of the whole family, even Tina's older sister Tabitha, who is now included in the family secret, they prevail, and Ted learns the value of family again. Tim's wife Carol is unfortunately tipped off to Baby Corp's existence as well, but overall, the status quo is reestablished until the Boss Baby, back in the crib. Adult Theodore is framed for embezzlement, and nobody believes he's innocent. Even me. To hide from the feds, he's forced to lay low with a family he trusts. Why not his brother? And laying low is even easier at crawling height, so with the help of the aforementioned super-duper baby formula, Ted is ready to re-embrace his identity and occupation as Boss Baby. So long as he can get Baby Corp to agree to rehire him, and so long as he can learn to adapt to modern business practices. Coddling the 5%ers. Well, hope you enjoyed that little coffee break. Now back to work. Stay tuned to Netflix After School for more videos about Boss Baby and all of your other favorite Netflix animated shows. My name is Noah. Thanks for watching.